Now, the next question here says, from the top of a cliff 150 meters high, the angle of depression of boats are 60 degrees and 30 degrees. We need to find the distance between the boats if first part says that if the boats are on the same side, and the second part says if the boats are on the opposite sides of the cliff. So if we understand the first part, it says that there is a cliff, let the cliff be AB, and there is a boat with an angle of depression from the top of the boat equal to 60 degrees. So let C be the first boat, angle of depression from here is equal to 60 degrees. So this angle is equal to 60 degrees, and this angle will also be equal to 60 degrees because these are like BD and line A are both parallel lines, right? And same ways, this is the other boat, and this angle over here, the angle of depression is equal to 30 degrees. So this angle is also equal to 30 degrees. And we need to find the distance between both the boats, that is DC or CD. In the second part, both the boats are on the opposite sides, but the scenario is the same. We need to find the distance between C and D. So how do we start the question? First of all, we have let the cliff be BA, right? Now, since BA is a perpendicular to the ground, therefore angle DBA is equal to angle CBA is equal to 90 degrees, right? Angle, I'm talking about both the figures, so I've written equations for both the figures. Angle DBA is equal to angle CBA is equal to 90 degree. Here also angle DBA is equal to angle CBA is equal to 90 degrees. So now we have also, we are given these angles. Now we know that angle ACB is equal to 60 degrees and angle ADB is equal to 30 degrees. Again, this is for both the equations. We know that this angle ACB is equal to 60 degrees and angle ADB is equal to 30 degrees. Right? Now, what do we have to find here is that if the distance between the boats. So how can we find the distance between the boats? If we know this distance AB, if we can find out BD and BC, we will be able to find out the distance between these boats. Here also, if we find BD and BC, we will be able to find the distance between the boats. We know that what is the relation between perpendicular and high and the base. Perpendicular and base, the relation is given by tan theta, right? So tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. Am I right? So if tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base, right now what do we need to do is we need to find out, we are given AB, first of all we'll find out BC. So therefore we have tan of 60 degrees, this angle is 60 degree, is equal to perpendicular, that is AB upon base, that is CB. Am I right? Now the value of AB is already given to be equal to, I didn't write the value of AB over here, AB is given to be 150 meters. Am I right? So the value of AB is equal to 150 meters. Tan of 60 degrees is equal to root 3. So we have from here, we have root of 3 is equal to AB is 150 degrees upon CB. Right? From here, CB will be equal to CB this side, root 3 this side. So we have 150 divided by root 3, which is also equal to 50 root 3. If you rationalize the denominator, we will get this value equal to 50 root 3. Same way, we will write tan of 30 degrees is equal to, now this angle here is 30 degree. I've also done this part for the second equation as well. We have this angle is equal to 30 degrees. This is angle 30 degrees is equal to perpendicular, that is AB upon base, that is DB. Am I right? This thing, this thing and this thing is true for both the parts, right? For first part, we have tan 60 over here. If you look at this figure, tan 60 is equal to AB upon CB, right? Perpendicular upon base. Now, if you look at this figure, tan 60 is equal to AB upon BC, that is the perpendicular upon base. Now, same ways, tan 30 is equal to perpendicular, that is AB upon the base, that is CD, right? Right. Now, from here, what do we get? Perpendicular upon base, perpendicular is AB and base is BD from here. And in the same way, we have base as BD over here and perpendicular as AB. So, this relation and this relation is true for both the figures. So, AB upon AD, tan of 30 degrees is equal to 1 by root 3, which is equal to AB is given to be 150 and DB, right? So, DB from here is equal to 150 root 3. Now, we have CB and BD for both the tan 60 and tan 30. We have the values of CB and BD. Now, this BD and CB is true for both the equations. Now, I need to rub this part. I hope you've noted it down. Now, all I need from here is this is 1 and this is 2. So, I'll be writing both of these equations over here. We have CB is equal to 50 root 3 and DB is equal to 150 root 3. That is all I need from here. This all is already done. So, I'm just erasing this. Now we have found out the values of CB and BD. Now, if you see carefully in figure 1 or in part 1, when boats are on the same side, the distance between the boats is CD. So, how do we find the distance? That is, the distance would be equal to BD minus C minus BC. Do you get it? The distance between the boats is CD. In the first part, we will find out the distance by BD minus BC. In first part, distance between the boats is equal to BD minus BC. Am I right? From here, this is equal to 150 root 3 minus 50 root 3. This is equal to 100 root 3. Am I right? This value is further equal to 100 into 1.732, which is equal to 173.2 meters. So, the distance between the two boats for the first part is equal to 173.2 meters. In the second part, if you see in this figure, the distance between the boats CD is equal to CB plus BD. Now, over here, distance between the boats is equal to CB plus BD. Am I right? Now, CB plus BD is equal to 50 root 3 plus 150 root 3. Correct? This is equal to 200 root 3. Now, this value is equal to 346.4 meters. So, the distance between the boats when the boats are on opposite sides of the cliff is equal to 346.4, and when the boats are on the same side of the cliff, the distance is 173.2 meters.